Good morning everyone. So this is chapter number 2, operating system structures, and we are going to study about the virtual machines. So this slide represents the contents of the operating system structures. Herein all the above topics are covered in the class. So the left topic was virtual machines. So in this slide, in this presentation, in this video, we are going to study more in detail about the virtual machines. Yes, before going for virtual machines in detail, let us understand the meaning of the word virtual. So virtual, let us take an example of the Bahubali movie, wherein Mr. Director Rajmouli Sahab has tried to create an imaginary world to create the film. When you see the making, you can see that it was just a mud and some toys, and some, we can say, some scriptures were created manually, and they were used to create the film or scenes in the film. Okay, so let us imagine about Bahubali going over the waterfall, up above the waterfall. So it was all with the imagination, nothing was real. Okay, the waterfall was not real. So now you can start imagining about the virtual. You can understand the meaning of the word virtual. So it will help you to exactly create the same thing that you are imagining. Okay, so these machines provide an interface. So whenever we try to create any virtual machines, they provide us interface that will make us believe that something, whatever we are using, it is of the same. It is something like a same. Even though it is not there, we can get a feel like it is the same. So this operating system creates an illusion that a process has its own processor. Okay, therein memory is being shared, or else you can say CPU is being shared. Okay, the guest operating system, whatever it is being created above the host operating system, will get a feel like it is having its own independent virtual copy of same underlying whatever it is there in the host system. Okay, so before going for the more detailed parts of understanding the virtual machines, let us have a brief history and benefits of virtual machines. The virtual machines was first appeared commercially with the IBM mainframes in 1972. So these mainframes were used fundamentally for multiple execution environments. So as I said in the previous example, we can imaginary more than one thing with the same machine, and we can use them for multiple executions. Okay, and these machines will share the same hardware. So another benefit, so one of the benefit is that it protect each other. So since there are different operating systems being imagined, they are isolated from each other. So any virus affected with one of the operating system, it does not affect the other. Okay, even though it is being isolated, some part of the file systems are being shared, and they are being allowed or being controlled to have a sharing. Okay, and these also communicate with each other using the networking. So further, when we go in detail, these virtual machines are used for development and testing. So whenever you start working with either of the companies, you will come to know how virtual systems or virtual machines will help you to do your work parallelly. Okay, and how you get your work done in the development area or testing area. Fine. So here we can see the typical diagram for your virtual machines, wherein we can compare two different systems. One is non-virtual machine as the A part, and B part as a virtual machine. You can see here in the A part, it is like your normal system, and B part, it is where we are implementing the virtualization, or else implementing or using the virtual machines. So there is an available of a layer called as virtual machine implementation layer that will help us to create different virtual machines on your host system, that is your single system. So now we are creating different virtual machines for each different number of applications that we are using. So here we can see that in the non-virtual machine at the A part, in the A figure A, Therein we can see, or you can get, the single hardware is there, single kernel is there, and single process is going on at a one time. So when we go for a B part, even though it is a single hardware, it has been shared among the different virtual machines. So sharing among the different virtual machines is carried out with the help of virtual machine implementation layer. So this layer also helps to create different virtual machines that you can see: VM1, VM2, VM3. So this VM1, VM2, VM3 is having its own kernel, and each kernel or each user system is processing its own application. So now you can compare both A and B figure, wherein you can get to come to know that your non-virtual machine may does not provide any multiple tasks at a single time, but your virtual machine will help you to do multiple tasks at the same time. So now let us go for the next slide. So when we go for virtual implementation, it is difficult to implement, because whenever we go for implementation purpose, we need some storage space. Herein, the storage space is a challenge. So suppose the storage space is available more like 1 terabyte or more than 1 terabyte, we can provide more, we can have more number of space with the host system. So now here it is, it will be very easy to create more disk drives that will be acting as a storage space for your each individual virtual machine. Otherwise, suppose consider the storage space is less, then here if we want to create more than one, more than 5 virtual machines, where are you are going to get only 3 drives, like that, like C drive, E drive, D drive. So, and you are going to create more than 3 virtual machines, okay, more than 3 operating systems you are going to use, or more than 3 virtual machines you are going to implement. At this time, we may say that it will be difficult to implement, as on all the storage space is a factor that is affecting. So whenever we go for virtual machines, the first thing that is to be considered is the storage space. So second thing to be noted is it will typically run on user mode. Okay, it will typically run on user mode. It creates user virtual user mode and virtual kernel mode, as we discussed in the previous diagram. The processes where single process was available in the previous diagram with that of the A part, but here in the B part, when we used virtual machines, we could have imagined 3 processes, that is creating a virtual user mode and 3 different kernels with the each individual processes, that is virtual kernel mode. Here and all, we can say the timings will be also an issue, wherein the resources that are shared will take a little bit of more time to shift from the host operating system to the virtual operating system. So you may have an slower working with that of the virtual machines. And lastly, the hardware support must be a most important need, so that if more support of the hardware is there, better visualization you can do, better virtualization you can do. Okay, so this is one of the example of your virtual machines, that is VMware, that we use for creating more than, or used for creating more than one virtual operating system in your host operating system. Suppose you are using Windows 10. Now you want to execute in certain programs in Ubuntu, like how we wanted to do with your Lab 2.5. So there was Windows 10 present already, and now the task was that we wanted to execute, or we wanted Ubuntu operating system to be installed in that lab. So at a time we got a challenge. So even not touching the host operating system, we have to install Ubuntu. But when we go for the traditional installation, either we have to create a separate distributed operating system, like creating two different operating system at the same time. But creating operating system out of the Windows 10 is really bit challenging. So we thought of using VMware. So when we started using VMware, since the RAM space available to work with that of the virtual machine Ubuntu, so we tested on one of the system in your 205 lab. So the space available was less with that of the RAM speed. That is, the RAM speed present in the lab is 2 GB. Now, for working with the minimum operating system, we need actually 2 GB RAM space, so that you can conduct the works normally. So now, if I install a VMware software and Ubuntu operating system within that VMware with Windows 10 with the 2 GB RAM space, it was working very slowly. That was a challenging for us. So we tested for more than 2 or 3 days. Later on, it was so tough to execute a program and it was very slow performing. So we decided to shift your lab from 205 to 306. And there with the utilization of RAM space with Windows 7 as when compared with the Windows 10 was less. And we created an alternative operating system. So now if you go and check the 306 lab while starting, you can observe two different operating systems are loaded. You can go for any one of the option. Either you can go for Ubuntu, either you can go for a Windows 7. So but if you are using Windows Ubuntu or executing any operating system lab programs, so you can go for Ubuntu and you can execute your lab programs. So here the architecture, how it works. At the lower level, it consists of a hardware. That is, it consists of a CPU, memory, and IO devices. These hardware parts will be shared among the virtual machines. At the upper level will be host operating system. Here, the host operating system is taken as a Linux. Now, you can also imagine with that of the Windows. Now, a VMware software, the VMware help us to get the visualization like virtualization layer. The virtualization layer will use the shared resources of hardware, okay, shared resources of the hardware, and creates its own copy with each of the virtual systems. Now here the virtualization is imagining about three different virtual machines. Okay, you can see there. So guest operating system number 1, 2, and 3. The guest operating system number 1 is having the free BSD operating system. Second one is having Windows NT. Third one is having Windows XP. So each operating system are imagining a copy of having the resource called as a virtual CPU, virtual memory, and virtual devices. So actually, when we see, there is only one hardware, okay, one hardware layer wherein only a single CPU, a single memory storage space is available, and IO devices are available, single components. So when we go for a virtualization layer, your virtual machine makes you imagine that each operating system, guest operating system we are creating, are having each different CPU, different memory space available, and different number of devices are utilized for each different operating system. So based on the applications, the operating systems are used, and your VMware software helps you to use these applications as an among different applications and help you to get done your work. Okay. So next example that we can see is your Java virtual machine. You have already used Java, you already did the Java programming in the previous semester. So your JVM helped you to execute your Java programs. So in the JVM, what it consists of? It actually consists of a class loader and a Java interpreter. It accepts the dot class files like a normal Java programs, whatever you did last time. And it will also accepts the different Java APIs. APIs in the sense, application program interfaces, or else you can say applications are based on running the different operating systems. Example, we can say as smartphones. These are having the different versions of Java, different tastes of Java like Lollipop, Android, and all. And when we compare with the diverse operating system of the smartphones, we can go for the iPhones. Okay, so even though these are all created using the Java, that is Java, okay. And these will all be executed at the virtual machine, that is JVM. So your Java virtual machine helps to execute the different class files at the same time, and so we can imagine it is a multitasking. Okay, fine. So this is the end of the chapter. Have a nice day. Take care.